Hello, I'm Dr. Janine Bowring, naturopathic doctor, and today I'm talking about how to take zinc to maximize its benefits. And yes, you can improve zinc's absorption by making sure that you're taking some accessory nutrients, which I'm going to discuss today. Thanks for joining me. Be sure to give me a big thumbs up and also stay tuned right to the end of the video so that you get all of the tips that I have to share. Make sure that you're subscribed to my channel and also turn on your notifications by clicking that bell so you always get my newest and latest uploads. If you do have questions at any time or comments, please leave them in the section below. I do get back to everyone. So, what is one of the things that we can take to maximize the absorption and the benefits of zinc? Well, one of them is called quercetin. So quercetin has been in the news lately, especially with what's gone on in the world. And what quercetin does is it's called a zinc ionifer, which actually means that it helps with the transport of zinc across the lipid membrane wall. And opening up that channel is very important for the proper absorption of the zinc. It also helps to inhibit the replication of viral infections, and that's certainly top of mind. One study actually proved and showed that in terms of increasing that intracellular zinc, it was quercetin was one of the natural agents that was able to do this. And that's important to note because whenever EGCG was another thing that was natural, and we know that EGCG naturally comes from green tea, but whenever we can increase the absorption of something that's helping us, we definitely want to do that, and certainly when it's from a natural source. And quercetin being a natural source ingredient can come from different natural foods that we may be eating. So some of the best sources of quercetin include capers. So capers are fantastic, so something that you can incorporate into your diet. If you're new to capers, then do your best to add them into your diet, as well as onions. So if you love onions, onions have natural quercetin, as well as elderberries and kale. So one of my favorite superfoods being kale will also help to increase your quercetin levels. And quercetin is a natural antihistamine, which I talk about when I talk about natural ways to combat allergies. But it's, again, something that's naturally occurring in foods that we can up our quercetin intake, as well as okra. So in some traditional diets, I know that this is definitely part of what you eat. So that also has the natural quercetin. Apple peels are fantastic as well. And blueberries and blackberries. So some of my favorite fruits also contain the quercetin. Figs are also a good source of quercetin, and cranberries as well. So again, there's different opportunities here to get some quercetin into your diet to help with that zinc absorption, as well as asparagus. Goji berries, one of the highest on the ORAC scale, are goji berries, and they help with our antioxidant status, but they also have that natural quercetin. And it comes from a flower. So when you're talking supplementation of quercetin to really get enough quercetin, and typically a supplement will have around, 150 to 200 milligrams of quercetin, is often extracted from this flower, the Sephora japonica flower, which is fantastic to be able to get it in that concentration. Concentrated form. Now, one of the things that can compromise your absorption of your zinc is copper. So zinc and copper work opposite one another. And if you have too much copper in your body, it will compromise your zinc absorption. And typically you want a ratio of about 12 to 1 of your zinc to your copper. So if you use a lot of copper pots and utensils and things, you could be upping your copper status. And if that's not counteracted by getting enough zinc in your diet, you could run the risk of developing a zinc deficiency. So in my episodes on the Dr. Janine Show, I often share the Dr. J9 truth about the subject matter that I'm talking about. And in terms of the Dr. J9 truth for zinc deficiency, it's really simple. In my mind, you're not getting enough zinc in your dietary choices. So maybe you're a vegetarian and, you've chosen not to eat meat sources, but we saw that, seafood and meats have some of the highest amounts of zinc, that you're simply not getting it in your diet, then you really want to take a good look at supplementation to ensure that you're covering up that zinc deficiency, because it's really, really important for your overall immunity, for the strength of your muscles, for your skin health. So make sure that you're getting enough, no matter who you are. Thanks for tuning in. I really appreciate that you're here. Be sure to give me a big thumbs up and hit that subscribe button so you always get my newest and latest uploads. Turn on those notifications by clicking the bell as well. Leave your questions and comments below. I'd love to hear from you. How do you get your zinc? And I'd really like to know. And I'll see you next time. Remember to always take care of your good health and do it naturally.